Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Hitesh and I'm back with another video. So today we are going to start our new series of Marvelous Designer. We're going to start from the very basics of this software. So we have the UI of Marvelous Designer, and if you look at the left, then you have all the different presets here. So you have all the character presets. If you double click here, we have all the male, female and the stylized character. If you select that and drop it in your 3D viewer, then you can see the character here, and you can create your clothes and your garments around it and start the simulation. And we have a different type of fabrics which are preloaded with Marvelous Designer. So this is our 3D viewer where we see the real-time simulation of our clothes or our garments. And this is a 2D viewer where we create shapes and we sew them. This is much like the Maya's UV editor. So on the right, we have this panel for our materials or our fabrics. So that any fabric we use goes here. And on the bottom right here, we have the property editor for all the shapes. So we're going to explore all the tools and all the menus later in the series. First, we are going to create a simple simulation of a pillow, so that we get the basic understanding of the software. So to create a pillow, what we need is we need two polygons, one for the top and one for the bottom. So if you go here in this shape icon, you'll get all type of shapes here like this. So all the shortcuts are also written in front of all the tools. So if I click on this rectangle or I press S, we get the rectangle, and we draw a rectangle here in the 2D view like this. So this is the first half shape of our pillow mesh. Now we need to rotate this if we want our pillow to lie down. So if I click here, we get this gizmo, and we can rotate this using this rotation gizmo like this. Now we need another shape so that we can create the bottom part of the pillow. What we can do is we can either create a new rectangle or we can just duplicate this one. So to duplicate this, you can either press Ctrl D like this, or you can also go here to transform pattern, click here, select your rectangle, then press Ctrl C and Ctrl V to duplicate your mesh like this. Now we need to rotate this, and the reason for the rotation is if I go here and select a point, then our point of this corner should match to this corner. But if I click here, then you will see that this is opposite. Now if we want to sew this edge to this one, then both the point should be here on these sides. So if I click this and go to edit, context menu, 3D garment, and flip this vertically, then you will see that if I click here, then we have a point here, and if I click here, then we have a point here. Now we can sew these two edges. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this up a little bit. Now we can start sewing the edges and run the simulation. Now to start with sewing, what we need to do is we need to go here and click on this segment swing. So you can press N also for the segment swing. And now we need to sew the edges. It's more like sewing the UVs in Maya or any other 3D software. So now we need to sew these two edges. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go here, click on this edge, then go here and click again. If these two lines on the both corners are vertically fine and they are not crossed, then that means your sewing is perfectly good. If you see any type of patterns like this, then this is not proper, this is wrong. So make sure both the sewing lines are perfectly parallel to each other. And if I click here, then you'll see that we have stitching lines here. That means that these two edges are sewed together. Now you can also do this in 3D viewer as well. So for that, what you can do is you can go here in the 3D viewer, select this segment swing, and now you can just click here and then here, and your edges will be sewed. So we have like two portions done. Now we need to sew these sides, and again you can go here and then here and click, and this one is also done, or you can do this in 3D viewer like this. Now our swing is done. To run the simulation, we just have to press space. So if I press space right now, then you see that this falls down and nothing really happens. And that's because we need to add a little bit of pressure to run the simulation of a pillow. Now what I need to do is I will go to this either in the 2D viewer or 3D viewer. So I'll just select this, both of them, and increase the pressure a little bit. Let's just say to 1. And I'll press space again to run the simulation. So if nothing happens, what you need to do is you need to go here, pull this up, this one as well, and again press space. So I think we need to add a little bit of more pressure. So I'll just go here and in the pressure, let's add 3, and now run the simulation again, and now we get a much better pillow shape. Now when you are in simulation, you can also tweak your simulation by clicking and moving your mouse like this. So you want to add a little bit of curls like this, or you want to remove these curls, you can just use your mouse and your left mouse button to tweak like this. So I think you understand the basics of creating a shape and sewing the edges to run the simulation. I'm going to finish this video here, and in the next one we are going to create a t-shirt, and in the more videos to come we will create more garments and understand the software completely so that we can create any piece of clothing we want. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, then let me know in the comments. And if you're new to this channel, then drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.